I'm here with you all to share my story and to tell you how I overcame not having legs. But with that said, I'm going to start from the very beginning. And unfortunately, I was born with a very severe birth defect that left both my legs deformed. And a lot of kids your age ask me, well, what do you mean deformed? So to give you all that understanding, here's what I'd like you to do. Well, all of you, take your hands and grab your kneecaps. Well, when I was born, my kneecaps were on the opposite side. When I was born, my legs were backwards. And that's how bad deformed my legs were. And that's how I got my full name. Rohan Mario Murphy. That's like so ring to it, right? Alright, fine, it doesn't seem. Most kids in schools, like yourself, don't really know or believe that the teachers or administrators in your school have the ability or the power to change your lives for the better. But trust me, believe me, they do. Because when I was your age, I was so embarrassed myself. I was so insecure. I was so ashamed because I was different. And growing up, going through middle school and high school, what I really wanted was just to fit in, be like everyone else, and have friends, and have a good time in school. And for me, when I was your age, when I was going to school, I wasn't just different. I was totally different from everyone else. But I finally got to the point in my life, I said to myself, I can't be a friend anymore. I have to live my life to the fullest. I have to be who I am. I have to be Rohan Murphy. And hopefully, all the kids in my school will be nice enough and kind enough to embrace me and accept who I am for the very first time in my life. For the very first time in my life, outside my own family, I felt acceptance. And I felt I belonged somewhere. And what I want from all of you is, not only in middle school and in high school, but for the rest of your lives, I want all of you to be inclusive, not exclusive. Be inclusive in life, not exclusive. When all of you in that cafeteria, invite more kids to sit at a lunch table. When all of you get married someday, I know it's a long way away, invite more people to your wedding. Be inclusive in life, not exclusive. And give people a chance and embrace different people from different backgrounds and different upbringings. Like my teammates or my kids in school did for me.
So I got Ethan up here, and when I started to wrestle, my coach, he was telling about this guy from Oklahoma named John Smith, legend in the sport of wrestling, all right? 10-time world champion, 2-time Olympic gold medalist. And he said when he wrestled, he invented a move, he used a move that no one else seen before, called a low single leg, when he would somehow grab his opponent's ankles and take him down. So my coach told me, if I was gonna wrestle, that's what I had to do. All right, so my coach obviously is a very bright, very smart guy. So when I began to wrestle, the very first thing he told me to do was to get down low, which is pretty easy enough for me, you know? So I had to somehow grab my opponent's ankles and take him down. So when I took someone down, when I wrestled, it went kind of like this. Ready?
Yep.
So here on out, I want all of you to begin to appreciate every single thing you have in life. I want all of you to be grateful for every single thing you have in life. Your family, your friends, and even the simple things that you guys don't think about on a daily basis. Like having your legs. Because trust me, I know for a fact that there are a lot of people out there in the real world, like myself now, they're never as lucky and fortunate as all of you. I tried my best. I really truly did. But guess what happened? I won. Now guys, this is an inspirational story.
And to be honest with you, I was having a very difficult time. I was stumbling, fell down a couple times, had to pick myself back up. And finally, made halfway to the 50-yard line. And Coach Lesnar told me I could come back. He said I didn't have to finish. But I told Coach no because I'm the type of person that when I start something, I'm gonna finish it.